Hello friends, welcome again at way2testing.com and my name is Chandan, and in this tutorial we will discuss about headless browser testing. What is it and how to implement this? We will discuss about these all things in our this tutorial, and with delay, let's move on little bit description part, which I have already posted in my blog in Selenium tutorial if you navigate. Then here is the tutorial of headless browser testing. I will give this link in my video description so that you can directly navigate to this page. So what is it and how to use it? The main thing is that if you are talking about headless, as the name is saying, that means this browser will not be visible to the end user, but it will perform his all operation. That's why it is also known as a ghost browser. And sorry, in terms of Selenium, browser which will be controlled by Selenium but will not be visible to the user is known as the headless browser testing. And we have very different kind of headless browser in the market, like first is you can say HTML unit driver, which is a very fast driver. Also it is a very favorite question of the interviewer, which one is the fastest driver in your Selenium. Your answer will be HTML unit driver. Second is the PhantomJS. It is also a very good driver. I will let you know these all things in detail. And some more driver we have, like one have the name as Ghost and Zombie, much more driver we have. Sorry, it's Zombie Z. And I think as Water Web driver we have, and much more driver we have. So first discuss about the HTML unit driver. And it is a very fast driver, as we know, because it's completely work on the HTML, and it has the pros and cons. The main pros is that it is a very lightweighted, working very fast, but the drawback is that in most of the application it is getting fail. In my code I have failed with this browser. So how to implement this browser, and more description you will get about this HTML driver on my blog. So let's move on. And here I have created a project where I have imported my all the libraries, and like Selenium jar files and test ng. I have added all the things. I just need to create a class for that. And also, first of all, you have to download the jar file for HTML unit driver. I have given the link to download in my blog, to download the jar file from the website. Also you can download the jar file from my drive. So suppose that if you want to download from the website, directly click on that, and you do not want to go to the website and you would want to download from my drive, you can also go from here. So just select your browser, select the required thing, and you can download this. Suppose that I want this one, I will click on this and the file will get downloaded. Here you have to click, I will download version 2.21. I have already downloaded, so I will not download it. I will make it cancel. And then you have to import that file in your project. How? As you have imported the other files, like other jar files that you have imported in your build path, configure build path. As you have imported other jar files, you have to import the HTML driver jar file. Like in downloads, I have HTML unit driver. And you have to download, add this jar file. I have already added, so I will not add this. Then you have to make it apply and OK. Then I will create a new class. I will give it way to testing HTML. Yes, I have created a class, and then I will write a very simple code. And you know that we are using the test ng from initial phase, so we will continue with that. So first of all, I will create a web driver global object for web driver class, and then I will create a before test ng annotation before test, and I will create a method public void g, and inside that I have to import something, import the web driver, and before I import the test ng annotation. Okay, now what you need to do, just create the driver object. Very simple, as you are creating otherwhere HTML unit driver. That's it. And yes, you have to import some files. After that, suppose that I want to navigate on my website, driver dot navigate dot to. It is also a good question from interview that why to use get and navigate. As I have told you that in navigate you can go forward and back in your browser, but with the get you cannot go do that. So suppose that I want to get the title of my website, which is waytotesting.com, and then I have navigated to that website, and then I will test. I am writing very simple code because my agenda is to describe the ghost driver. Public void h, and I will just print the title. So I will write this out, control space, and then I will print way to testing website title is I have to give it comma or driver dot get title. Very simple. I will run this code and I will check whether my title is getting printed or not. I am running it, and test engine has been started. You can check it out here. And yes, it is getting passed because it is a very easy code. So I think that my title has been printed. It is a title, best online software testing tutorial, software testing. Now it's all about the HTML, but in most of the case, suppose that you have some complex code and you are working with a lot of the filters, lot of the drop down and drag and drop functionality over there, then this browser will not work anymore. So I will not recommend it anymore, because I have already tried in my real life scenario and it was not working in most of the cases, and it is not visible to you, so you will spend a lot of time to get the actual problem what is happening. So second is the PhantomJS browser. Also in my, if you will go to my blog, I have written over here, you can download the PhantomJS file from my Google Drive or some other. If you want to download the PhantomJS, you have to do two things. First, you have to download the jar file, and second, you have to download the bin. If you click on this link, you will navigate to the that you have to download this zip file. I have already downloaded, so I will not do so. And second thing, you have to download the jar file, and make sure the version you have choosing for jar not appeared. If you are not choosing the appeared version, you will get an error. For the version somebody is completely 1.4, so choose the version according to your need for the jar file. And when you will download this zip file, you will get something like that. Like I have already downloaded, so I will make it cancel. So